up. You will push me forward. You will give me an advancement in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Open your mouth and say, Father, the Bible says the anointed that breaks the yoke. This is the anointing service. I want you to say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every yoke of affliction in my life, every yoke of depression is hereby broken. Open your mouth and begin to call on the name of Jesus Christ. What is the yoke that you want God to break? Is it a yoke of anger? Is it a yoke of depression? Is it a yoke of addiction? What is that yoke you are expecting God to take care of this morning? Open your mouth and say, Father, every yoke that needs to be broken today, every yoke that needs to be broken off of me, every yoke of unbelief, every yoke of disappointment, every yoke of sickness, because I am here this morning. You said the anointing is the one that breaks the yoke. He can tempo shia kai poshaka yabosha. He can keye bobo shaya kintere. Every yoke of confusion in my mind, in my soul, in my body. Every yoke that is blocking my view. Every yoke that is not letting me see you, hear me. He can tempo shia karabosha. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I said, Father, my head will not reject the anointing. My body will not reject the anointing of God today. The anointing will say to me, will take care of my situation. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and say, Father, I thank you for what you're about to do in today's service, O Lord. King of glory, have your way this day. King of glory, show yourself mightily. King of glory, open your mouth, O Lord, and say, Father, show yourself in my life. Show yourself in my situation. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, everlasting Father. Lord, we commit to this morning service to your holy hand. King of glory, send your Holy Spirit even into our midst, O Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, have your way this day. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Friend. Hey. I'm Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for privilege. Thank you, Jesus, for the sacrifice. Thank you, Jesus, for the love that you call us your own.
Yeah. we thank you this morning. We lift our hands before you, Lord, in adoration. We bless your name because, God, you are worthy. We bless your name because, God, you are able. We bless your name because, God, you are mighty. Lord, we lift our hands in your presence in adoration of who you are, oh God. You are the mighty God, the great I am. And so, Lord, our hearts are lifted before you. Lord, we praise your name. Our hallelujahs, Lord, belong to you. My hallelujah belongs to you, oh God. Oh, the praise belongs to you, Father. Oh, the honor belongs to you, Father. Our worship belongs to you, Father. We praise your name because, God, this morning, your word says you have a plan for each and everyone. And so, Lord, we come before your presence. All hands raised up to God. If you can lift up your hands before the Lord and begin to worship him, because there's something new that he's gonna do. This is our anointing service. And when you come before God for the anointing, something special is gonna happen. The Bible says in the book of Romans 8, and for those who are here from the morning, the Bible study, we've dwelt in the book of Romans 8. I don't know why, but I believe there's something God is speaking to us. Romans 8 and verse 11. We are talking about restoration. Our theme for this month is, I will restore health unto thee. But Romans 8 and verse 11 says, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you and I, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies. He will quicken your mortal body. If the spirit of God that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, if that spirit dwells in you, the Bible says that God will allow that same spirit to quicken your mortal body. And so this morning, we are in God's presence. This is our anointing service. The Bible says in Acts 2 that when the Holy Ghost comes upon you, thou shalt receive power. Now, when the Holy Ghost comes upon you, you receive power. But when you allow the Spirit of God to dwell in you, then he will quicken your mortal body. Lift up your hand before God and begin to worship him. Begin to worship him because he's quickening your body. Begin to exalt his name because he's doing it for you. He is healing somebody. He's restoring someone's health. He's restoring someone's health. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, everlasting Father, we thank you. We bless you, God, because you are restoring somebody. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh God of all creation, receive all the honor and all the glory. We bow in your presence, oh God, because your word, Lord, has said, but if the Spirit of God dwells amongst us, that our mortal body shall be quickened in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God of all creation, we bless you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We exalt your name, my Father, because there is power in your word. There is power in your spirit, oh God. There is power in your presence, oh God. There is power. Lift your hand before God. Continue to praise him. Continue to worship him. You can sing a new song to him. You can talk to God in your own language and in the spirit, because today is the day that the Lord has confirmed from the Bible study and up to now that this is the day he's going to refill you. He's going to refill me. He's going to refill us with the new touch. Because when he refills us, then our mortal bodies shall be quickened. Every sickness shall leave in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The lame shall begin to walk, and the blind shall begin to see, and the dumb shall begin to hear, because of the Spirit of God that dwells in you and I, in the name of Jesus Christ. Everlasting Father, we thank you, because there's miracles, oh Lord. There are miracles in this place, oh God. There are miracles in this place, oh God. There are miracles in this place, oh God. We thank you, Father. You can proclaim that verse this morning and ask for God to refill you one more time, to refill you once more. Let His Spirit dwell in you. Let the Spirit of God quicken your mortal body. Let that cancer begin to live in the name of Jesus. Let that prostate cancer begin to live in the name of Jesus Christ. Let that diabetes begin to live in the name of Jesus. Because the Spirit of God is quickening your mortal body. Yes, Lord, do it, Father. Let your mortal body be quickened this morning. Let that virus live in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the Spirit of God is quickening your mortal body. Restore us, O Lord. Restore us, O God. Restore good health unto your people in the name of Jesus. Lord, we bless you. We worship you, my Father, for you are good God. And this morning, Lord, there is a confirmation that the Spirit of God is at work in this place, and every vessel is being refilled in the name of Jesus. That our mortal bodies are being quickened in the name of Jesus. Let your presence, my Father, take over now in Jesus' mighty name. We pray that, Lord, this anointing service shall be a refilling service, and that everybody will begin to see great things happening in their lives in the name of Jesus, because the power of the Holy Ghost will begin to manifest as the anointing comes upon us this morning. Lord, we empty ourselves that we may be empty vessels to be refilled, because you are looking for an empty vessel that you may fill with your Spirit, oh God. Lord, we pour, Lord, let every work, my Father, that you are going to manifest in this place this morning through your word. Lord, we are ready for your word. We are ready for your word. We are ready for your word, oh God. Speak to us, oh Lord. Speak to us, my Father. Receive all the honor and all the glory. And the church say, amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together and appreciate the Lord. Let's put our hands together and appreciate the Lord. Amen, amen. Are we excited? Before you take your seat, turn to your neighbor, to your left and to your right. You can wave at your neighbor. You can wave at your neighbor. And you can smile at your neighbor. Amen. Amen. It's so wonderful. It's so wonderful to be in this place. I know that God is doing something special. And I can feel it in my spirit. In the morning when we went through the Bible study, you know, this Romans chapter 8 is what God had put in my spirit this morning. In my devotion time. And the Bible says that he who raised Jesus Christ from the dead, that Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead, because he was raised from the dead by the Spirit of God. And the Bible says that if that Spirit dwells in you and I, that Spirit will quicken our mortal bodies. And if you believe in the prophetic theme of this month, I will restore health unto thee, all you need to do is let every other thing go and prepare yourself that when the word of God comes, let the word of God come and refill you, that Spirit of God will quicken your mortal body. Every sickness will begin to go. Every challenge in your life will begin to leave, because you do not belong to them, you belong to God. And if God dwells in you, great things are going to happen in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen. And so this morning, very quickly, I want to take this opportunity to welcome us back into the house of the Lord. And on behalf of our senior pastor, Dr. Steve Fagbule, and on behalf of our covenant mother, Pastor Kimi, I want us to put our hands together and just appreciate the Lord, because we made it. Amen. We made it. Amen. 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 We made it here, not by our own means, but by the help of the Lord. Amen. There are many people out there You know, they can't even lift their one leg out of the bed. Not because they don't want to, but because the body cannot make it. But God has chosen to allow you to come out here. So don't leave this place the same way you came. Make this your home. Make this your home church. This is the best place to be for us who have been here now for some time. Oh my. I don't want even to hear about going anywhere else. Amen. I don't know about you, but I also came here. If this is your first time, I also came here just like you for the first time, and I never left. So don't leave, because this is the place where God wants to establish you. Amen. And if you allow yourself to leave, you will come back in Jesus' name. Amen. Because this is the best place, and we thank God for that. And so I want to take this opportunity to give one praise report. Usually we receive the names of those who want to give their testimonies. When you come in, you leave your name with the usher, with our ushers. But I know we have not learned that lesson very well. So keep reminding us that we make it our habit when we come in, we leave our names with the ushers. Sister Diane, Grandma Diane Foster, I see you there. Please make it here and let's hear your testimony. Amen, amen. Let's have the microphone. And I don't want to rush you, but I want you to not to preach, because we have the preacher of the day. Amen. You know, ministers of God, when they come to share their testimonies, they open the whole Bible.
Congregation today. Last night I was, yesterday evening, I was resting, but the Holy Spirit don't never let me rest. When he spoke to me, he wanted me to say something about when I was a child. I said, I don't remember all that. He said, well, you got burnt in your head by a pot-belly stove. Anybody know what a pot-belly stove is? Well, you had to use coal and fire and wood, and I got burnt in my head. But the Lord healed that.
Amen.
And he said, you have work to do. A lot of illnesses that I had, he had shown me that a lot of things that come up against me is because I had a call on my life. And that I would be doing a lot of things. Now, thank God for me today. I thank God for who he has made me to be today. I thank God for all what he's doing around me. I have a ministry that's reaching out to the East Coast as well as the West Coast. I have people calling wanting to minister in my ministry, and I thank God for that, you know, because we're trying to connect women to women, because we need to stand up behind our men and fight for our men, pray for our land, pray for things. We have a lot to do as women. Instead of sitting at home cooking behind the walls and stuff. We need to be out here sometimes on Saturday around these hospitals, surrounding the hospital, praying for our doctors, our nurses, our technicians and all, and the people that's in there that's ill. And I thank God, you know, I took the vaccine. I'm weak right now, but I'm okay. The devil tried to keep me home in the bed. I said, not today. Not today. You go home to your bed. So we have to rebuke things that try to come and attack us. In Jesus' name.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you, Sister Diane Foster. Amen. The Bible says that the harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. Sister Tammy, as you get ready, we can take one more praise report. It's a lovely one, please. Once you're ready, let me see by a show of hand at the back. Amen. It's a lovely. Make it.
Good morning, church. Welcome to another wonderful service in His presence, where there's always fullness of joy. Is this your first time of worshiping with us? This is the Covenant of Faith Family Ministries.
Today he turned 19, and I just want to thank God for giving him 19 years of life. And I just want to thank God for everything that he's been doing for our family.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Okay, Sister Christine, please make your way here. Sister Lovely will always make sure that we don't hide any praise report in our family. So if you don't want to give a praise report, she'll always make sure she comes and give thanks on our behalf. We have an attorney in the house. Amen. Amen.
Giving honor to God, my mama and my pastor, and my daddy right there. Yeah, I want to thank God for one thing. The other day, I fell at work. Oh, real hard, like, bam, on the ground. It hurt. Like, it really hurt. But then God took it away, and it was like that. It was gone. Pain was gone. So I want to thank God for my job, for all of you all here in my church. And I love all of y'all. God bless all of y'all. And wake me up this morning, because I'm going to be dead. I'm going to be alive. I thank you for that. For everything. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. The Bible says that the Lord will command the angels to hold you. So when you fall down, the angels were there already with their mattress. So you fell on the mattress. That's why you didn't hurt yourself. Amen. God bless you, Sister Christine. Amen. Amen. Are we ready at the back, Sister Tammy? Brother Jeff? Amen. We have an announcement. And as they get ready, I want to just kindly ask us not to leave in a hurry unless if you have to. Amen. Because if you leave midway, then you'll say that the pastor said this. So stay until the end of the service, amen? Then you'll know what to go and share out there. Amen. So, Brother Jeff, let's dim the light at the back so that we can have a good view.
Good morning, church. Welcome to another wonderful service in His presence. Where godly families are raised, built, and restored. We are glad to have you in our midst. Welcome to our year of total restoration. Do enjoy the service. Our activities. Our Sunday worship service starts with a Bible study at 10 a.m. while the worship service starts at 11 a.m. You can catch us live on Facebook or watch us on our YouTube channel, Covenant of Faith Family Ministries. It is our year of total restoration. Mondays at 6 p.m. on Zoom is our Covenant House Fellowship Bible Study, where we discuss situations that affect our everyday life by digging deep into God's Word. Please do join us as we study the Word together. Our Covenant Singles and Adults meet on Tuesday at 6 p.m. on Zoom. See Pastor Kenny and Pastor T for more details. Single and ready to mingle. Wednesday is our midweek service come Bible study. We look forward to having you here in church, or you can join us live on Facebook at 6 p.m. Those that come for the midweek service will not be weak in Jesus' name. Thursday is the meeting day for our covenant royalty. We meet on Zoom at 6 p.m. It will be right to come to the youth night. Our Covenant Hour of Prayer holds every Friday at 6 p.m. on Facebook. Our senior pastor, Dr. Fagbule, will be our host. It is a season of exceeding grace. Please do come with your expectations, as they shall all turn to testimonies. Amen. Our Hosanna Night comes up every last day of each month at 9 p.m. Do come along with friends and family, as it is always a night of praise and prayer to our covenant keeper. Our covenant sisters meet on Zoom every second and third Saturday of the month. Also, the Jewel's Army every second Saturday on Zoom. For all Zoom links, please see Pastor Barry or contact him through the numbers displayed on the screen. Honor thy Lord with thy substance and with the first fruits of all thy increase. So shall thy barns be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall burst with new wine. Proverbs chapter 3, from verse 9 to 10. Here in the Covenant of Faith Church, we encourage tithes and offerings. Different channels have been set up to aid this giving, and they are being displayed right now on the screen. God enrich you mightily as you give. We make church function through the various groups, the hospitality crew, they make sure we have something to eat on Sundays like this. We have the praise team, the ushering department, the children department, the media team, and the sanctuary keepers. If you're interested in joining any of the group mentioned, Please do see Pastor Barry. It is our Father's house. Let's make it work. We also give back to our community with a program tagged Feed My Sheep. It's a food bank where we give food to the underprivileged people. God will bless you mightily as you donate both your time and money. Also, we have the Transition House for Women. Please see Pastor Barry if you're interested in being a blessing unto others. This month of March is our month of I will restore health unto thee. Jeremiah 30 verse 17. God will completely restore every ailment and diseases in Jesus' name. If your birthday, wedding anniversary is this month, please let us know so we can celebrate with you. Are you a covenant child? Yes, I am a covenant child. As you go this week, show love, kindness unto others as you invite them to church next week. May the covenant-keeping God bless you. From the media team, we say stay safe. We love you all. Shalom.
Again for that wonderful clip. Amen. And so we are going to have the praise team minister to the Lord. And after that, I want to prepare us, make sure when the word of God is coming, carried by the servant of God, we need to stand up. Amen? It is very important. And I'll remind you again and again, when the Ark of the Covenant was being brought into the city of David, it was something else. I'll talk about that next time. So it is important when the man of God is coming to the pulpit of the word of God that we all arise. We may not respect him, but respect the word that he comes with. Amen? Amen. May God bless you.
Receive glory. Worship and in humble adoration of his name. Why don't you lift up your voice and just lift up your hands and just appreciate God this morning.
Amen.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. You are slain so that you may receive power, honor, glory, riches, wisdom. Thank you, Jesus, for your atoning death. Thank you, Lord, for the sacrificial lamb that was slain. We give you praise, Lord. We worship you. We magnify you, Lord. Receive our worship. 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 Spirit of the living God, we welcome you into this place. Spirit of the living God, come and dwell richly in our midst. The Spirit of the living God, come and restore life, restore the health of your people. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Fall fresh on us. Fall fresh on us. Listen, Teres, honorable. Male sentere zundara mama male sotorobo. Male zundara male sentere. Spirit of the living God, for fresh on us. Oh, thank you, Jesus. There is no like you, Lord.
Amen.
On this covenant day, on this day of our anointing for total health, ask God to be quickened by His Spirit.
Amen.
Let the power of the Lord come down to quicken our mortal bodies. Is somebody speaking to the Lord right now? Is somebody speaking to the Lord right now? Lord, let there be a quickening. If that same spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead resides in your mortal body, that same spirit will quicken your mortal body. There's somebody you've come to this day with pain, with weakness. There is a quickening happening right now. There's somebody, they told you that organ is dead or is dying. There is a quickening back to life right now. I said there is a quickening back to life right now. They said there was a checking. There shall be a checking this morning. There shall be a quickening this morning. Flesh upon flesh, bones upon bones, in the name of Jesus. The army of God will rise again. Thank you, King of Glory. King of Glory, fill this place. Just wanna be with you. Just wanna be with you. King of, is somebody just lifting up holy hands before God right now? Ha ha! Hallelujah!
Just wanna,
oh, lift up those holy hands before God this morning.
Just wanna be with you. Yes, Lord.
We bow down and say, you are God.
Every man would bow down and say, you are King.
Oh, why don't you start right now?
So
Let there be quietness in the house right now. The King of Glory is in the house. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We return all praise, return all glory back unto you. In Jesus' mighty name we have worship. Let's put our hands together. And you may all please be seated in God's presence in Jesus' mighty name. I know you've welcomed your neighbor. You can also give them a thumbs up right now. Give them a thumbs up right now. Because God is here already. He said in his presence there's fullness of joy. In his presence there is fullness of joy. And in his right hands there are pleasures forevermore. Whatever issues of pressure that came with you into this service will turn to pleasure situations in the name of Jesus. The King of Glory is in the house. And I know as many that will connect faithfully with their heart, they are going back today a changed person. From glory to glory. Say, as we all, beholding him as in a glass, the glory of the Lord, we are changed into that same image from glory to glory. So as you behold the word of God in the glass this morning, that word will transform you. It will translate you. It will turn your story to glory. It will turn your pains to gain. It will turn your captivity to celebrity. It will turn your tests to testimonies and your trials to triumphs in the name of Jesus. If that is for you, let your amen say so. The Lord has declared this month unto us as a covenant people. I will restore health unto thee. Hallelujah. I will restore health unto thee. Who said it? Who said it? And God that said it, he would do it in the name of Jesus. In Numbers 23, verse 19, he said, God is not a man that he will lie. If he says it, he will do it. If he says it, then he will do it. And I see him doing it for you even before the end of this service in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is in the business of restoring health. And I know that you will not escape his impartation even this month in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. You know, we started a series at the beginning of this month that we titled, Is There No Balm in Gilead? according to Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 22. Hallelujah. For the heart of my people are hot. I was blacked and astonished. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is the health of the daughter of my people not restored? And we concluded that the word of God is the balm in Gilead. And Jesus is the physician. That as you engage the word of God, you will be restored back to your total health. As you take the prescription from the physician, Jesus is the great physician, and the word of God is his prescription. And when you commit yourself to being compliant with the prescription, you will be restored back to your total health. And I know that will be yours in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. According to Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20 to 22, he said, my son, attend to my words and incline thy ear to my saying. Let it not depart from the midst of thy heart, from thy eyes, and keep it in the midst of thy heart, for they are health unto them that find it, life unto them that find it, and health unto their flesh. And in the same Psalm 107, verse 20, he said, he sent his word healed them, and he delivered them from their destructions. In Proverbs 4, he said, my son, attend to my words. In Psalm 107, he said, I send my word. My word healed them. In Proverbs, attend to my words, and it shall be life and health unto you. What does this mean? When you go to the hospital, they give you a prescription, and they tell you, take this medication for so many days. When you take it, start with the first medication, you start feeling better. But until you take the whole medication, that you can be truly healed and cured. But many times, once we take the antibiotics, the first one, the fever subsides, we forget taking the remaining. And what happens? That sickness comes back full force. The same way with God and the word of God. When you receive the word, he sent his word, it brings you healing. But when you now receive the volume of the words, then you go into the realm of living in health and vitality. God's will for us is not to be healed at all times. God's will for us is to live in what? In health. As a child and sons and daughters of God, you are meant to live in health. But it takes my son attending to my words. Not just receiving one word and you believe that is all you need. You must continue in the words for you to remain in health. God will heal you with an encounter. With an encounter, God will heal you. But for you to sustain that healing and to remain in health, you must continue in the words. Hallelujah. One leper met with Jesus. 10 lepers met with Jesus. One encounter. And they were healed. But one returned to receive more of the words. And what happened? He was made whole. Somebody is going here whole in the name of Jesus. I say you are living from here made whole in the name of Jesus. So, last Sunday, we looked at covenant understanding for fulfilling our days. And we said, it is God's will and God's covenant for us is to live to a good old age. We said death no longer has power to determine how long you live here on earth, because Christ has destroyed him that have the power over sin and death. According to Hebrews chapter 2, verse 14 to 15, he said, for as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him that have the power of death, that is the devil, and deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage. Many, through their fear of death, have been subject to the bondage of death. The Bible says fear has torment. The things you greatly fear will come knocking at your door. But God and the word of God is saying to us here that Jesus has destroyed him that has power over death. And according to Revelation chapter 1, I believe verse 8, Revelation chapter 1 verse 8, if you have it up, I am the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. Saith the Lord, and which was and is to come. Check Revelation chapter 1 verse 18. It says, I am him that liveth and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of hell and of death. Jesus went to the grave. So to obtain the key of death from the devil. so that the devil cannot use it against you any longer. Hallelujah. He said if Satan had known, he would not have crucified the Son of God. Because by him going into the grave, he went to restore back life unto you. And he handed that one that has the power over death. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. So now, how do you restore your health and secure your life? Number one, you must believe in the validity of the covenant. And what is the covenant? We said it last Sunday. What is the covenant? In Genesis chapter 6 and verse 3, the Bible says, and the Lord said, my spirit will no longer strive with man, for man is flesh. Hallelujah. For man is flesh, and all the days of their life shall be 120 years. That is the covenant. That is the covenant. That all his days shall be 120 years. So yours is to believe in the validity of that covenant. Hallelujah. What is the covenant? In Isaiah chapter 65 verse 20. There shall no more ends an infant of days, nor an old man that has not filled his days. For the child shall die 100 years, but the sinner shall be 100 years old and be accursed. That is the covenant. So at 100 years, you are still regarded as what? As a child. So don't think you are 70, you have 65, and you think you are old. In the eyes of God, you are still a child. He said, the days of a man shall be like the days of a tree. And you know trees, they have longevity. Hallelujah. People of God, what do you believe? Like we were told this morning, in John chapter 1 verse 12, it is what you believe that you are able to become. As many as received him, gave him power to become sons of men, even those that believed in his name. What do you believe? Do you believe that the enemy can just take you anytime? Or you believe that God has said it and that settles it? He said in Luke chapter 1 verse 45, blessed is he that believeth. For there shall be what? A performance. There shall be a performance of those things that were told. What do you believe? What do you believe? I believe I will not be cut short in the midst of my days. I believe every appointment with death is swallowed up by God in victory. I believe grave have no further hold over my life. I choose the time I want to go. Death has no more power over me. People of God, It is not me saying it. I'm saying what God has said concerning me. Hallelujah. Until you give bold declaration to what you believe. He said with the heart, you believe unto salvation. But with your mouth, you make confession unto your righteousness. Hallelujah. Until you are able to say it, that the devil will hear it. The devil will not flee. How do you secure your health and longevity? Number two, walk in the fear of the Lord. Somebody say fear of the Lord. Living a righteous life. You know, sin brought death to man, and redemption brought life to man. Righteousness will exalt a nation, but sin is a reproach. Pursue and walk the walk of righteousness. Righteousness is not a state, it's a journey, it is a process. Hallelujah. Pursue righteousness, pursue holiness, without which it is impossible to see God. In Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 2. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 2. Said that thou mightest fear the Lord thy God, to keep all his statutes and his commandments, which I command thee, that and thy son, and thy son's son, all the days of thy life, and that thy days may be prolonged. That thy days may be prolonged. How many of you have your Bible in church this morning? You have your Bible? Because now people don't bring Bible to church. Please, bring your Bible to church. Even though they put it up there, bring your Bible to church so that you can go back, you mark it. You know exactly where it is. Don't come, if you don't have your Bible, at least have Bible in your pad or something, so that when they don't show it, you are able to go there yourself and you can connect. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 2. That thou mightest fear the Lord thy God, to keep all his statutes and his commandments, which I command thee, thou and thy son, and thy son's son, all the days of thy life, and that thy days may be prolonged. In Proverbs chapter 14, verse 27, the fear of the Lord is the fountain of life. And to depart from the fear of the Lord is a snare of death. You see many people dying cheaply. Young folks, why? Because the fear of the Lord is gone. The fear of the Lord is gone. You see people defrauding other people. Gun violence. The fear of the Lord is gone. And you see our young and our youth dying. Why? Because they have not been shown the way of the Lord. He said, fear the Lord, your son and your son's son. You have a responsibility. If he or she is still on, is under your roof, you have a responsibility to ensure that they have the fear of the Lord in their hearts. What we see today is not what God wants, but because the fear of the Lord is lost. And most of us will have to answer to the Lord regarding these things. You know, when death came calling to Ezekiah, in Isaiah chapter 38, verse 3, Ezekiah knelt down and spoke to the Lord. Oh Lord, Isaiah 38, verse 3. He said, remember how I served you with a perfect heart, how I walked before you in truth, and have done that which is good in thy sight. You know, Ezekiah brought the record of his righteous walk before God. And God said, no, I cancel this death sentence. I'm adding additional 15 years to your life. So the walk of righteousness can prolong your days. How do you secure long life and a life of health? Like I've said already, number three, you must commit to live by the word, both by hearing and speaking the right words. What you hear influences what you become. In Job chapter 6, verse 25, he says, how forcibly are right words? How forcibly are right words? What do you hear? What are you hearing? Many have opened themselves to death because of what they hear. But when you come to atmosphere like this, you are hearing words of life and you are declaring life to yourself, you begin to live. When this pandemic came up around this time last year, we were declaring life and everyone here was declaring life. And God gave every one of us life. God preserved every one of us. Why? Because right words have a force of influence. If you are just there during the pandemic, instead of coming to church, it's just people are just seated in front of the TV, hearing bad news, hearing how many deaths. No wonder the angels of death began knocking on their doors. What are you hearing and what are you saying? Life and death are in the power of your tongue. God has given you life, and I say, I will not die, but live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. There is power in your tongues. When people are saying, oh, anyone can be a victim of this pandemic, you say, except me. Except me. Why? Because I have a covenant with God. I have a covenant with God. The power of living by the word, through hearing the right words, and through speaking the right words. Many has inadvertently brought death into their home by what they say. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, he answered and he said, man must not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. You must live by the word. You must live by the word. Hallelujah. You know, there are certain informations that only ends up deforming you. You don't need those information. Death cannot strike without first having the fear of death. And I decree that you are delivered this day from the spirit of the fear of death in Jesus' precious name. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and of a sound mind. Jesus destroyed death. Sickness does not have power over you. He said, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. How can you secure your health and long life? Number four, you need to be committed to kingdom service. Somebody say kingdom service. You need to be committed to a life of kingdom stewardship. In Exodus chapter 23, verse 25, said, and thou shalt serve the Lord thy God, and I will bless your bread and your waters. I will take away sickness from the midst of thee. Exodus 23:25. I will serve you, for thou will serve the Lord your God, and I will bless your bread and your waters. And I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. And thou shalt not cut your young, nor be barren in the land. The numbers of your days I will fulfill. Somebody will fulfill their days in the name of Jesus. I say you will fulfill your days in the name of Jesus. I say you will fulfill your days in the name of Jesus. But it starts with you serving God. God says, if you serve me daily, I will service your life and your body daily. If you serve me, I will service you. If you serve me, I will service you. It is the covenant. God cannot allow you to be in hospital bed when he needs you in his house serving. God told Pharaoh, let my people go that they may serve me. God is committed to keeping and preserving you for your service. People of God, how do you serve God? You serve God through your kingdom advancement prayers. Through your kingdom advancement prayers, serving God, praying for souls, praying for the word of God to have free course, praying for your pastors, praying for ministers, that they continue to receive a revelation from God. That each time you come before God, they are giving before God in Zion, they are declaring the word of God according to the needs of the people. How do you serve God? You serve God through a life of soul winning, witnessing both to the young and to the old, witnessing to the Jews and to the Greek, witnessing, winning souls for God, because that is the heartbeat of God. How do you serve God? Serving God in different areas, in the ministry, to ensure that the gospel is spread. You know, every time we play the announcement, and it says, "Oh, there's platform for service, hospitality, media, praise team." I'm not sure if that has touched somebody to say, "Oh, let me talk to pastors this, where I would like to be a part of this. I want to join this. I want to do this." Service in God's kingdom brings prolongation of days and gives you fulfillment. Hallelujah. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20, the Bible describes you as an ambassador for Christ. Now then, we are what? An ambassador for Christ. Why? Because you are reconciling. God has brought you into the ministry of reconciliation. Then, what did the Bible say in Proverbs chapter 13, verse 17? When you become an ambassador for Christ, that is a guarantee of health. He said, "A wicked messenger falleth into mischief, but a faithful ambassador is health." When you serve your role as a faithful ambassador in the ministry of reconciliation, you begin to enjoy health and vitality. Somebody shout hallelujah. How do you secure your health and longevity? Number 5, be committed to dwelling in the house of God. Somebody say, house of God. And where is the house of God? The house of God is Zion. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 22, he said, "We have come to Mount Zion, the city of God, the living, the heavenly Jerusalem." We have come to Mount Zion, the city of the living God. So each time you come to Zion, you come to meet with God. And in Psalm 84, verse 7, he said, "They go from strength to strength. Every one of them appearing before God in Zion." So, The enemy is a stupid enemy. He would do everything to keep you away from church. And I believe this pandemic was part of the devil's agenda to keep people away, to shut the doors of churches so that they can be under the yoke of the enemy, under the grip of death. But thank God we recognized it early and we did not fall into that device of the enemy. We did not fall. I can say, at least based on my understanding, in this city and nearby, we will be one of the, our church was open more than any other church last year. And there was no one record last year that any one of us got that virus. Not one. The glory returned back to God. Why? Because we're working based on understanding. Not because of the wisdom of men, but in the demonstration of power and of the Holy Ghost, based on revelation. Because we will not do or say anything that God has not revealed to us. He said they go from strength to strength, every one of them in Zion appearing before God. And Zion is the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, where we have numerous hosts of angels. Hallelujah. There are angels around here. We are standing on holy ground, and there are angels all around. Let us praise Him, Jesus, now. For we are standing, I'd like you to rise up on your feet, in His presence, on hold. Again, we'll have to continue the message next Sunday. Next Sunday is going to be our covenant day of fruitfulness. Somebody say fruitfulness. Somebody say fruitfulness. And we shall... God is said to restore fruitfulness to you. If you're looking for the fruit of the womb, the Lord will restore fruitfulness to your womb. If you're looking for fruitfulness in your career, in your business, the Lord will restore fruitfulness to your career. Everything that you have lost in the course of this pandemic, everything that you have lost in the course of this impasse, the Lord is set to release you into a season of fruitfulness. And I want you to understand something. That when God has declared a matter, He will be there to ensure the fulfillment. So just lift up your hands as we're about to receive the anointing. This is anointing for total health. The Spirit of God is that which is in the anointing. And the oil is only a medium of communicating the Spirit of God. The oil itself is not that has the power. But by God's and His wisdom, He has chosen the oil as a medium of communicating the Spirit and the power of God. He said concerning Samuel in 1 Samuel chapter 13, chapter 16, verse 13, that day the Samuel anointed David with oil. And what came upon David from that day forward? The Spirit of the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord is a carrier of the power of God. So don't just look at the oil. Look at the Spirit of God. And don't just say, oh, this is ordinary olive oil, and you just go there and I can get it anywhere. It takes impartation of that Spirit for it to be able to manifest in your life. He said in Isaiah chapter 27 verse 10, he said, by reason of the anointing, Isaiah chapter 10 verse 27, by reason of the anointing, yokes shall be broken, burdens shall be lifted. He said, it shall come to pass on this day. Somebody say this day.
This day.
That the body shall be taken away from my shoulder. And the yoke shall be taken off my neck. And the yoke shall be destroyed. Because of what? Hallelujah. The anointing is God's last card against the agent of death. The anointing is God's empowerment. That was the last card that quickened Jesus and brought him out of the grave. Whatever grave you have found yourself, whatever organ in you doctors have said is dead or is dying, as you receive this impartation with this anointing, I see every dead organ that needs to be alive quickened back to life in the name of Jesus. I like you to just speak a word to the Lord right now. Anointing for my total health. I want you to speak to the Lord. As I receive this anointing, let my quickened mortal body, let my body be quickened. Let my body be quickened. Let my body be quickened. How God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. And he went about doing good, healing those oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. I say, as you are anointed, you are going to be dispensing healing, because you are going to be an ambassador of health. You shall be an ambassador of health, because you shall be dispensing healing. He said they go from strength to strength, as many appearing before God in Zion. Oh, Father, Lord, we thank you. Spirit of the living God, fresh on me. I just want you to go ahead and touch that to your forehead and just begin to pray. Let's do that quickly. The anointing shall heal all manner of sickness and diseases. In Matthew chapter 10, verse 1, Jesus gave them power to heal all manner of sickness and diseases. Nothing will escape this empowerment of the Holy Ghost today in the name of Jesus. The doctors might have told you this one is a big one, this one is a tough one, but by this anointing that is coming upon your life, he said he gave them power against unclean spirits. Every unclean spirit here is being cast out of you, and is to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of diseases, whatever name it has been called, whatever name the devil has called it, trying to cut short your life, trying to cut you in the midst of your days. Maybe they call it high blood pressure. God will be giving you normal blood pressure. Maybe they call it diabetes. God is giving you normal glycemia. Maybe they call it kidney disease. God is restoring your kidney. Maybe they call it heart failure. Maybe they call it congestive heart failure. The Lord will heal all manner of sickness, all manner of diseases. Maybe they call it bipolar disorder. Maybe they call it schizophrenia. Maybe they call it paranoid schizophrenia. Whatever name they might have called it. Maybe they call just the issue of blood. Maybe they call it lumbar stenosis, arthritis, degenerative diseases. Maybe they call it COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Maybe they call it coronary artery disease, atherosclerosis. Whatever name they call it, all manner of diseases is being met right now. Is somebody speaking to the Lord? I don't know what yours is, or what is in the life of that your loved one that you need God to touch right now. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Male son torobo zundaramama. Le sentere zundaramama. Anointing.
Upon our lives, and every sickness and disease has left in the mighty name of Jesus. That no one amongst us that has received the anointing under the sound of your servant Lord, shall bring a bad report. Every report has been changed in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the anointing, and we thank you, Lord Father, for the prophet who brought the word. Because your word says, if we believe in your word, we shall be established. And if we believe in the prophet, we shall prosper. Let every health now get better. Let every life be changed in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together and appreciate the Lord. Amen. Let's appreciate the Lord. 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 Amen. Amen. Let's take our seats in God's presence. Amen. I want to believe we are blessed. Are we blessed? Let me see by a show of hands how many people are blessed. Let me see how many are blessed. I am blessed. Amen. And you can shout, you are blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. Amen. Amen. And so shall it be in Jesus' name. And Jacob, when he was blessed, he said, I will return to the place where I saw the vision. I will return to Bethel, and I will give a sacrifice. I will offer unto the Lord a sacrifice. Amen. And I told you one time, I told you some times back that we don't give because God is poor. No. We don't give because God needs money. No. He does not need money. He is not poor. But God wants you to come before him. Even before I talk about God, I've heard this amongst us people. That let him show you that he loves you by actions, right? So how do you love God? By actions. Show God that you love him by your actions. Abraham took his son Isaac, and at the slaughter table, God said, I've seen your action. Stop. Don't put that knife on your son. I've seen that action, Abraham. You are a man who loves me. Now, if you love God, bring out that offering, that sacrifice, that seed, your tithe. A tenth of what you get belongs to God. Amen? Amen. Amen. You know, you cannot eat tithe and have enough. But that's one thing. You can try it, but you cannot eat your tithe and have enough. When the stimulus come, you find that your budget is more way over the stimulus. When the tax refund comes, your budget is way over the tax refund. But one thing, if you are faithful to God, he will make sure you do not borrow. He will make sure you do not beg for bread. He will make sure you're not homeless. Amen. If you are faithful to God and you are homeless, come here and we'll give you a tent. You cannot do that. The Bible says, David says, I was young and now I'm old. I've never seen a righteous of the Lord beg for bread. You'll not beg for bread in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Lift up your offering before God and begin to give thanks and say, Father, I'm giving from the depth of my heart, and I am glad that I have the opportunity to come and give to you. I'm not giving complaining. I'm giving rejoicing in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. If it's your first time, you can give by text. Just compose the text, write the amount you want to give, and send it to 559-205, and then to take you a few seconds, you'll be able to give. If you are online, you have the information there on your screen. Please go ahead and give unto the Lord. Write your check to Covenant of Faith Family Ministries, and God will bless you. Father, we thank you. We bring this offering before you, Lord, with gladness of heart, oh God. What a privilege, what an opportunity to come before you, Lord, with something in our hands, oh God. We pray that, God, may you accept it, and may this be a remembrance before you, Lord, of our lives, of our families, of our jobs, of our businesses, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Receive all the honor and all the glory. And the church say, amen. Amen. So come dancing, amen. Dance and give unto the Lord, rejoicing.
My fears are
Because of the anointing, every yoke of financial stagnation, every yoke of financial bondage, stretch forth your hands towards this altar. I declare every yoke broken in the name of Jesus. I decree your liberty in the name of Jesus. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 55, it says, death shall be swallowed up in victory. I decree and I declare, everything that represents death in your life, 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 55, everything that represents death around you, your loved ones, they shall be swallowed up. It's like, oh grave, where is thy sting? Grave, where is thy victory? Why? Because Jesus has swallowed up death in victory. I pronounce life over your life. I pronounce liberty over your life. I pronounce restoration over your life. I pronounce quickening upon you, upon your life, upon everything that you hold there. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have made this declaration. Amen. 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 Is somebody excited? Is somebody happy? Hallelujah. Is somebody here and today is your first Sunday? Please have your seat as we welcome our very important guests and visitors. This is your first Sunday here on a Sunday, first time here on a Sunday morning like this or Sunday afternoon. Can I see with a wave of hand, this is your first time of coming in here? Praise the Lord. Wow. Can I encourage you further to rise up on your feet so that we can see you and celebrate you? Please rise. God will give you, God will honor you, and God will love you to take a step of faith again and come to the pulpit as we welcome you with a song. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. We can see all over you the glory of the Lord. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. You're welcome. God bless you. I'm sure the people want to see you. Praise God. Thank you. Can we know your name and who invited you?
My name is Sherry Williams, and Kimmy invited us. This is my daughter, Amora Williams, and she came with me.
Sister Sherry and Sister Maury. Maura, please don't leave.
My name is Brother Derek.
Mommy and Pastor invited him. Mommy, I will say. Please, let's stretch forth our hands towards them. The Lord brought them this day. On this day of anointing, God has a plan and a reason. He said, on this day, by reason of the anointing, yokes shall be broken, burdens shall be lifted,
and yoke shall be removed from off their shoulders. Let's pray that any burden they have come into the house of God with is not going back with them. They are dropping it here at the feet of Jesus. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. God will grant them rest from all their labors and their troubles in the name of Jesus. The anointing of God shall break the yoke in their life, and they will come back with their testimony in Jesus' name. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let's rise up as we close the service. Please, this front row, just sit down there. Once we finish the service, let's, and then we'll all share the grace of God together. Let's rise up as we share the grace of God together. Next Sunday is the last Sunday for the month, and it's going to be our Thanksgiving service. Praise the Lord. And it's also going to be, like I said, our covenant day of what? Shout it out if you know it. Praise God. I think I can hear you from the middle. Shout it out from there. Shout it out from here. Covenant day of fruitfulness. Praise the Lord. And you shall be fruitful in the land in the name of Jesus. Everything you lay your hands to do shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus. And Easter Sunday is in 2 weeks' time. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Are you excited to celebrate Easter in church? Last year, we celebrated Easter in our homes, and that was not a happy thing for me. And I am glad that we are here to celebrate Easter together as a family. And I know that same spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead will quicken your mortal body. And we will all encounter the resurrection power in the name of Jesus. So, we will look forward to seeing you and having you. And we will be giving us more information regarding the program for that weekend in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, let's rise up. Let's sing our song. We are here. Of the Father, we are anointed with the Son. Goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Peace. Shalom.